Alright guys, today we're going to replace the electric water pump for a 2000 VW Beetle, a 1.8 turbo. So the piece we're going to change is this one here. So as you can see, I don't know if you can see, but the part, this hose is broke right there, so we need to replace the whole part. So okay, so let's do it. All right so first thing we need to do is remove the connector, but also we're gonna remove that bolt right there, so two bolts right there. So, but first, we're gonna do this connector here. So, you're gonna press these little clips. You need to press down. I'll show you again. So, just press it down and pull it like this. Alright. So now we need to remove those two bolts. Okay, but first we have to remove this hose clamp here. So we have to remove this hose to have more room. So flush. Okay, so I got it back. Oh, again. Okay guys, so I removed the hoses and also removed this little hose here. So now I have more room to stick my hand inside here. Okay. So take this clamp. Oh, man, it hurt. There you go. Okay. So we move this hose to the side here. So now we need to remove these two bolts here. Alright, so I have one of these tools here. So this is a T30. So I switch my tool, get a wrench, okay, so I want to remove the two bolts and I'll be back. Okay. Take here is our like auxiliary water pump. So you can see it was broke from this outlet here. So we need to remove that part from that hose right there. So alright, so I'm gonna remove that part right there and I'm gonna go get and buy this part, and I'll be back in maybe in a few. Okay, remove that hose right there. Clamp, we need to use this tool here. So this tool here. So you wanna buy it, or here's the numbers. Let me see. I don't know if you can see the number here. Right there. So it's a really good tool. I got this tool for almost 10 years now, so it's a really good tool right there. So here for now, I'm gonna take it out. Be careful with your fingers. Okay guys, so take it off. There you go. So now we need to remove this piece here. Okay. Yeah. And the thing we're gonna do is set the pliers like that. I don't know if I can do it with just one hand. Let me try it. Okay. I'm gonna squeeze it. Here you go. There you go. Now let's see. Little press right there. And go like this. And shake it. Alright. So it's empty now. Alright. Here's the four pieces. Okay, so we got the new part here, and we got the same connection. It's Bosch. So now it's time to put it back. So we're gonna put the brackets first. So we're gonna install that part right there. So let's do it. Okay, so the thing that I like to do always when this kind of clamps, I use a zip tie to put it together like this. It's easier to do it, easier to install the bolt. So yeah, so as you can see here, it's easier to put the clamps back. So we're gonna tie these bolts here. So now we're gonna install also this hose here. So Okay guys, so as you can see, we have some installed the bracket. So now we're gonna put back this one, the top post. Got the top post now. We got the bottom post. So now we'll reconnect the electrical part. Okay, so now we're gonna add coolant, and also gonna put back these hoses too. So we're gonna add this antifreeze, the premium, and it's for BWs. So this guys is concentrate. So when it says concentrate, you need to add water, half and half. So here's one half, and I got my other half over there. So let's add some antifreeze. Add some antifreeze. As you can see, it's like pink. So let's go and start the car. Have to make sure that we have no leaks here. So far it looks good. And here we need to add more coolant. Okay, so now you have to let the car running for around like 15-20 minutes and check the coolant level, and I think that's it guys. We need to wait till the fans start working, the radiator fans, and when they start working, you're good to go. Alright guys, thank you very much, and I'll see you next time.